Hello, everybody, and welcome. I'm Brian DeMars for ChannelFireball.com, and today I'm going to be doing an Ixalan Draft League. So I've been writing a lot about Ixalan Limited. I've been playing a ton, and let's see where we wind up here. So this pack is kind of interesting. I usually look to start in Merfolk if I can, if there's a great Merfolk card, but there isn't. So what do we have going? There's a lot of good cards in this pack, so this is going to be like kind of an important first pick. There's cards that I think are worthy of first pick. There's a Talani's Knight. There's an Ixalan's Binding, a Savage Stomp, an Anointed Deacon, a Vampire's Yield. These are all cards, a Skullduggery. These are all like potential first pickable kind of cards here. I don't love green if it's not Merfolk's. I mean, this is kind of a Merfolk card, but green is kind of difficult in certain instances to draft. I'm going to go with the Binding because this can put me into various dinosaur decks and or like a vampire deck. So I think this is the most flexible pick. Savage Stomp is like an okay Merfolk card and a decent dinosaur deck, but I don't want to be green if I don't have to, unless I'm Merfolk. So that was why I took the Binding. Skullduggery is fine. I think this is just a good little answer card. It's very flexible. We can do a lot of things with it. So with that in mind, the Ranging Raptors is a pretty good dinosaur card, and it may well be the best card in this pack. The Fleet Spy is okay. Not great. Needs like a certain kind of deck to get paid off, but it doesn't have a huge board presence, and I'm all about board presence in this format. So the Siren's Lookout and the Ranging Raptors are probably the two best cards in this pack. So I think I'm gonna take the Ranging Raptors since I think it has potential to pair with this Ixalan's Binding. I don't mind being green white. I don't love it, but I think this card is good enough, and I don't want to be like a blue white skies deck because I want to get paid off for tribal synergies. So took the Ranging Raptors. So this pack, the best cards in the pack are the Siren's Lookout, the River Herald's Boon, the Bishop Soldier, and the Anointed Deacon. I could still try and do this white vampires sort of thing by taking the Bishop Soldier. No matter what, it'll pair with the Ixalan's Binding. Even if I wind up green-white, the green-white decks, I think, want to be a little bit defensive and come over the top. And I do have a nice start for like a green-white dino deck, and a Bishop Soldier will meet my two-drop requirement. I'm very big on drafting with my curve in mind. So with that being said, I think the pick, you know, I'm very far away from Merfolk. A third pick, River Herald's Boon, isn't anything to get too excited about. I think the real pick here is between the Deacon and the Bishop. I'm going to take the Bishop because it allows me to be more open, and I just think that two drops are just very important. So I'm going to do that. So now we have sort of a big decision to make, and the big decision is whether or not we want to make a jump into like a vampire deck or stay flexible. So there are three cards in this pack that I would consider taking: the Call to the Feast, the Inspired Cleric, and the Territorial Hammer Skull. These are, no matter what, it's going to be a decent pick. The only way this pick can really go bad is if I go, you know, if I make this black-white commitment and I wind up being green-white or something else, or even, I mean, I could even be red-white at this point. So I think it's between the Cleric and the Territorial Hammer Skull. I'm going to go with the Hammer Skull just because I think it's a more powerful card. If I wind up being super, like a super sit-back deck, I may wish that, or vampires, I may wind up wishing that I had gone with the 3-2 that gains the 4 life. But I do have, you know, now two very good dinosaurs. I could be looking to be a green-white dinosaur deck. And, you know, that's what I'm going to do. And even if I do wind up being black-white, which, I mean, it doesn't, like, look like we're getting shipped a lot of black cards, aside from the pack where we had the Bishop Soldier and the Anointed Deacon. I guess we did get past the 4-drop make 3-1-1 lifelinkers. But So maybe green-white is the way to go. And we have some nice green-white cards in here because we have a Petrodon Knight and a Grazing Whiptail. I think that this is a close... we do have a Goring Ceratops. This card's kind of lame, though. It costs a zillion mana. I think I'm gonna push the dinos here. I think Grazing Whiptail and Petrodon Knight are sort of close. But if I want to be a little more defensive, I may want the Grazing Whiptail in this deck. So Grazing Whiptail it is. It's a very close pick, I think. But I've been very impressed with the Whiptail, and it does give me some dino synergies since it looks like I'm gonna be more of a dinosaur deck here. I guess I could have taken the Petrodon Knight and sort of stayed open. You know, maybe I still am a black-white deck. But, I mean, black does not look particularly open. So that's sort of why I've decided. There was no immediate decision to do this, but the course of the draft, I feel like, has incentivized me to move in this green direction. I think black is not very open. Green is more open. So, and, you know, we're getting paid off. The best cards in this pack are green cards for the most part. So, or there's a lot of green cards. I mean, the Queen's Agent is pretty good. You know, if you need a 2-drop, the Bay Soldier Scout is fine. But I think the pick for me is going to be the Diviner, and I'm going to be looking to build maybe a ramp deck, maybe a mid-range deck, a more defensive style deck. I do like the Ravenous Daggertooth. I think it is a better card than the Diviner, but if you look at my curve, I've already got 2-3 drops and they're quite good. This Ramparts may or may not make the cut, but I do need 2-drops and I want defensive 2-drops. So Bishop Soldier is a good one and Diviner is a good one. It'll either be a 1/4 or a 0/3 that drew me a land, which I probably need if I'm going to try and go a little bit higher on the curve. So there is nothing in this. See, this is crazy. We saw no black cards and then all black cards. I don't really care about River Herald's Boon, so it's probably too late to switch colors, but I'm going to take the Deacon just in case something crazy happens. You never know. Did something crazy just happen? I don't know, but I'm taking another Deacon. I'm not going to play Duress either way. Old Growth Dryads is a card that I think is playable, so people hate on it, but I've played it. I play it about half of the time it winds up in my deck, depending on what my deck is. And in the decks where I play it, I believe it to be an above average card. So I'm just kind of going through the dregs of the pack here. There's nothing spicy. These double Deacons, though, got punished for not being black here. Let's see. So I gave up a card for the Ranging Raptors. I gave up a Petrodon for the Grazing Whiptail. So this could still be a black-white deck. We're just a little bit behind. So I need to get my act together here and focus because I'm clearly, in 3 colors, but this double Deacon is a very strong incentive to be black-white. So another good black card, very good black card. Makes me really wish I'd picked that black-white card. There's a Walk the Plank, which is a very good removal spell. Luckily, green, well, maybe luckily, unluckily, green is not the best color in this pack. Bishop is very good. I think the play here is to take the good white card because I'm not going to be black-green. I think the black-white is just trending to be better here. I don't really need another 5-drop so badly as I need to make sure that my deck is a deck, because if I switch colors, I'm going to be a little bit short. Pious Interdiction is going to make my deck either way. My white cards are better than my green cards. My black cards are better than my green cards, but I have less of them. I don't think I have any black cards in my sideboard. So I'm going to take the Interdiction. So this pack has good green cards for the green deck that I wanted to build. The white card that's worth taking is the Slash of Talons, which is fine, but it doesn't really fix any problems that my deck has so far. The green card does fix a problem. It is a good two drop. I don't have two drops in a deck that needs two drops. And it wants two drops that are exactly like this. So I don't really give anything up to get the Deacons. My draft was trending towards being this green-white deck. I could take the white card or the much better green card. I'm just going to take the better green card. I'm probably going to be green-white here, despite this weird super late anointed Deacon thing that was going on. So there, the best card in this pack is the Shapers of Nature and the Water Trap Warrior. Well, we do have a Merfolk. I guess I could switch into blue-green because this draft has been so all over the place. The Deathless Ancient is also one of the best cards in the pack. Or I could just take Slash of Talons. I think that this train is kind of sailed away, as they say. The train has sailed. They say the ship has sailed, but the train sails too sometimes. I don't know. I think I need to stop worrying so much about what else is in the pack and just get on board with this green-white deck. Slash of Talons it is. This is a good card in this deck, too. So we get paid off for finally making a decision. And to be fair, we didn't give anything up to pick these Deacons. They just showed up, and I thought it might be a sign that maybe I would get the most insane deck ever. And it was right to pick them. But the Wild Growth Walker, I think, is going to be a nice little addition to this deck. I already have two Explore creatures. It's a good blocker. I will need to pick up some of the high-end cards in green-white, but I'm not too worried about that yet. If I wind up with a deck that's like all Wall of Woods and no payoffs, I'll be sad. But Wild Growth Walker is a nice little card. So now it's between the Bishop Soldier or the Ixalan's Diviner. I think Bishop Soldier is like just enough of a better card that I would pick it over the Diviner, even though I just picked up a Wild Growth Walker, which makes me kind of wish that the Bishop wasn't in the pack, but I know better. The Bishop is better. And I'm going to pick it. So there's an Imperial Lancer, an Old Growth Dryads, and a Raptor Companion. Where am I at? I don't think I have anything that cares about dinosaurs. I do have my two drops like fairly rounded out, which would be a nice pack for like a Raptor Companion. I don't really want to play this Ceratops. I think it is kind of a stinky card. So, with that being said, I don't really have a ton of Dino Synergies. Lancer's not that good. I think it's just another 2-drop. You can't really go wrong having a bunch of good 2-drops most of the time. So, there's really nothing in this pack. This is a great pack for a Pirate Mage. Look at this Fiery Cannonade and Cutlass. I could take the Cutlass because I have two Bishop Soldiers, and it is kind of a nice pair-up, but it's expensive. I'm going to take the Lancer and probably play it. So we have a Ravenous Daggertooth, another Dino for the Dino Synergies. Now I kind of wish I'd picked the other Lancer, but part of the reason the Lancer got so good was that I picked up a Raptor Companion. So nothing in this pack besides a Jungle Weaver for the sideboard. A very late Deepwood Warrior. This shouldn't be in the pack. I might splash it. I'm going to start looking into that immediately because that card is just good. It's the kind of card I'd like to splash. Especially in a defensively oriented deck. I don't think I have any fixing, but maybe I could get like a New Horizons. This might be an old growth dryad deck. I'm not sure. I have a prying blade that I can try and splash off of. A swamp that will go to the sideboard. I like this. I have the two removal spells at the top, the Grazing Whiptail. The Ranging Raptors is a nice help me splash card. I had a high concentration of I'm sorry, I lost my train of thought. I had sort of a lot of explore cards for where I was when I picked the Wild Growth Walker. Less explore cards now. So this is an interesting pack because it's going to make me make a call on combat tricks. So I think the combat tricks are the best cards in this pack. Between the Vampire Zeal and the Crash of Ramparts. Kind of disappointing for a first pick. These are not cards that I would want a first pick, but then again, outside of being red, which I was never close to doing, Captain Lannery Storm, probably the best card in this pack, followed by the Freebooter, and I wouldn't even be happy to pick a Freebooter, so, and I was never even close to being red. So it's between Vampire Zeal and Crash of Ramparts. I have a slash. I do have this one drop. I think I want the one mana combat trick. I think this deck is starting to become more focused on being aggressive. And we get a great card here. This card is so good. This card is almost impossible to beat in a super aggressive deck. And look at that, my deck is super aggressive. So Walker of the Wilds it is. Charging Monstrosaur. Green card's so good in this pack. Or red card's so good. But I wasn't in red. So I don't think this is like necessary. This could be necessary. So it's between Skyblade of the Legion and Raptor Companion. I'm afraid the Skyblade just won't hit hard enough in this deck. I don't have any great way to make that good, and I have the Lancer. So I'm gonna go with another 2-drop, take the Raptor Companion. I don't think this is the deck for Wild Growth Walker or Ixalan's Diviner, but Merfolk Branchwalker is just generically awesome. So happy to have that. Speaking of just generically awesome, Tishana's Wayfinder in this pack is a nice pickup. As the only card in my colors, so that's nice. Take the Wayfinder. Put it into my cards. And there's the New Horizons that I was hoping to pick up out of a bad pack, which is exactly what I have here. For what it's worth, this is a card that when I draft with people online, when I do like join me's and Skype or whatever, nobody wants this card. I love this card. I think this card is bananas. Very, very powerful, especially in an aggressive deck, because your opponent just, it's almost right to just give your opponent the 3 cards every time and just cut your losses and say, fine, you got a 3-mana concentrate, because taking the damage and giving them any combination of cards is just a gigantic beating. But New Horizons is a card that I've been very impressed with, and it will help me splash my Shapers of Nature. Oh, wow. What do we got here? So 2 good cards, River Herald's Boon and Tishana, Voice of Thunder. I'm sorry, I didn't have the preview pane up this draft. I apologize for that. So Tishana, power toughness equal the number of cards in your hand, and you have no maximum hand size, and when it comes into play, draw a card for each creature you control. It's very powerful. I don't want to get too caught up into that. I now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Merfolks. I think I'm just going to take the River Herald's Boon here and be happy. Look at this. This is craziness. I think Vineshaper Mystic is one of the best overall cards in the format. I don't have a ton of Merfolks here, though. It might just be worth it just to take it. It's a 3-mana 2/4. just no matter what. And when you pair it up with one of these two drops, it gets even better. I already have a ton of great two drops as well, so I'm just going to take the Vine Shaper Mystic and hopefully get one more green two drop in here. So there's a New Horizons. I love New Horizons. Crash of Ramparts or Ravenous Daggerclaw. This deck needs more Crash of Ramparts, so I'm very happy to take it. So Prying Blade or nothing. I'll take nothing. Ixalan's Diviner for the sideboard in case I need to get more defensive. Prosperous Pirates for the sideboard. Blossom Dryad. Wonder. I don't have any payoff for this, but like, I do have two New Horizons. And that card is very good with New Horizons. Just taps to add two mana to your mana pool. So, this was kind of a crazy draft. But it wasn't that crazy. I just picked two Anointed Deacons and made my head explode thinking about what was going on with these Deacons. I wound up with sort of a dinosaur merfolk deck. So I'm just gonna move everything to my sideboard and we'll build it from the ground up because I think that is a good way to build a magical deck. Look at all these green cards. So Walker of the Wilds is definitely in. Wayfinder will definitely make the cut. Ranging Raptors, which helps us splash Shapers, is definitely in. Definitely going to play both Crash of Ramparts. Branchwalker will definitely be in. Deep Root Warrior will definitely be in. You know what? I'm going to leave the spells out for now, even though they're kind of important. I want to see what my curve looks like. Then Territorial Hammer Skull is in. Vampire. I just said what I was going to do, and then I did the opposite. And then I have, I guess this will, I'm playing this for sure, but it's really not a three drop. So put it over here. So I'll put these two drops in. I have six two drops, which is kind of what I like. That's only 11 creatures, so I think the Vine Shaper Mystic is good enough that it'll be in no matter what. This Imperial Lancer Swamp. Where are you, Imperial Lancer? Oh, you went over here. So, creatures I could play. Imperial Lancer, there's no more white creatures. Grazing Whiptail. Ravenous Daggertooth. Where'd it go? What is going on? Went into my deck. It's a sign. So I think I just want to play all of these. And that gets me to 15 creatures with a pretty nice curve, low curve, which means I should be able to pressure early and play from ahead in some situations. So I'm going to add Crash of Ramparts, another good utility card in this deck. Oh, that's New Horizons. New Horizons also going to be great in this deck. I'll add that as well. So that's 19 playables. I don't know why I'm adding these to the four drops. My two removal spells. Put those in the four drops. Vampire Zeal seems sweet. So that's 22. And then I have a Slash of Talons that I could play. I have a Blossom Dryad that I could play. I have a Prying Blade that I could play. And I have a River Herald's Boon that I could play. I think River Herald's Boon is the card here. I don't have a ton of Merfolk, but if I ever get to do it on a Merfolk, it'll be great. I also have this Imperial Lancer. Just a lot of good opportunities to do stuff with the River Herald's Boon. So this is my deck. Let's take a look at the mana. Let's see what and I do think that this is probably a 17 land deck. Because one of the lands is an island. So let's see what it suggests. 6, 10, that can't be right. So, how's that look? More green than white. I think 881 is where it's at for this deck. 881. Okay, so green white, Merfolk, beatdown. I don't know. What do you think? Did I do a decent job? Would you have drafted this a little bit different? I don't know. I'd have to go back and watch the video, but I felt like I made pretty solid decisions in this draft. So I don't know if you saw a pick that you think derailed my draft into green white Merfolk. Be sure to drop that down in the comments. You know, if you like the video, hit the like button, and be sure to subscribe to ChannelFireball.com's YouTube channel there. If you looking for some good content, good way to get ahead of the curve. But anyway, I'm Brian DeMars. This is my green white draft deck, and I will be back in just a minute for round one. Thanks for tuning in. Hello, everybody. Welcome to round one. I'm Brian DeMars. I'm playing a green-white Mer-Dino deck in an Ixalan Draft League, and I won the die roll, so I'm going to keep. No good, Mulligan. Acceptable. So let's see what we have on top. Imperial Lancer. That seems okay. Let's keep that on top. I wish this was a hand of seven that let off on this, that's for sure. So go little planes go. And ship the turn. So now I've got the option between the Raptor Companion or the Imperial Lancer. I'm just going to throw out, I can double spell, but it doesn't matter next turn. I'm just going to play the Imperial Lancer out. If I draw, I can play the Ranging Raptors next turn, and then the New Horizons the next turn. We'll see what my opponent does, though. Okay. So I have options. I could play the Wayfinder. I could play the Raptors. I think I'm just going to play the Ranging Raptors and not attack, because this thing will be better next turn. If I draw, I can block this. They probably will not attack, even if they have a pump spell. The Ranging Raptor, pretty dangerous. Next turn, depending on what they do, I can play New Horizons and put the counter on the Imperial Lancer. So that was a nice draw. Put the counter on the Lancer. Get this Raptor into play. And bring the beats. So I wasn't going to get around that either way, but unfortunate. Lightning Strike is really good. It's like one of the best overall cards that somebody could have. I was thinking maybe a Shore Strike to trade with the Lancer, which I would have been fine with. Well, that was not a great draw step. See if we can find a pump spell somewhere. Nope. I think I'll trade off this Raptor. So let's see what our opponent is going to go get here. I have some nice payoff cards. It would be nice to draw them since I have so much mana. Either the Shapers of Nature. Or I could just draw another Plains. Maybe this is a 16 land deck. So I don't really have any kind of good attack here. So, I kind of just need to draw something. My opponent doesn't have... Well, they don't have good attacks, but their attack that never stopped them from attacking, now did it? So I do want to do this. I'll go get Island, even though I have, I guess, blue mana. But you never know, that I could get demolished or something. I at least can play my blue spell. Well. I'm just going to attack because I'm not going to be able to block that thing. So, this game has gone horribly wrong. I've drawn 5 spells and 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 lands. I mean, you're never winning that game. I guess that was a reason not to attack, but, I mean, what do you expect me to do? I'm going to lose this game unless I draw another forest. Oh boy. I could still draw like one of my awesome cards and theoretically get out of this. And that's what I'm playing to right now. But they kind of had it all. They lightning strike my good threat and I drew 10 lands in a row and died. So this is 9. I don't know if I can get out of this. They still have 2 cards. Presumably not 2 forests. That's a good draw. That's a lot of damage. I don't know if I can get out of this. That was actually kind of stupid. They shouldn't have done that. It's better on the pirates. I die. So let's go to the sideboard. I'm going to try boarding out of Plains. the shock. See if I have anything else that feels like it could be good. Maybe the old growth dryads. They don't seem like they have too many things to ramp into and no splash. No, I'm just going to run it like this. Try with the 16 lands. Now that I think about it, with the new horizons, 16 lands are probably fine. So I'll probably change my deck to just start that Slash of Talons every time. Acceptable. Hopefully you can draw some green manas. I didn't board out green mana, which is good. So now I'm in trouble because I need to draw a Merfolk and green mana, which is going to be difficult. That was a terrible draw step for me. Okay. So I only have one play, so I might as well make it, I guess. Draw a couple of forests, and this game is going to be on. Make my little 2/4. Probably make my little Territorial Hammer Skull. Forest. Give me forest. Why do you not listen to me? I want to bash with both. It's not like a ton of payoff for not bashing with both, so I'm just going to bash with both. I'm going to leave my mana up and hopefully my opponent will not block here. Just take the damage and then I can use this Territorial Hammer Skull to pressure them. Make their blocks different. I still like just need to draw a forest. I have 8 of them. Almost a 1 in 3 chance of drawing one every draw step. Any land will give me the ability to they might just pop off this. Oh, it's only the artifact or creature. Okay. Hopefully I can draw a forest. A forest would be completely bonkers here. Forest will let me River Herald's Boon to just eat things. Oh, sigh. So I think the play is that we just have to keep on pushing. And I'll tap down the worst creature so that they have to block with the better creature. And 2, 5, 7. I mean, chunking some damage. Mana Screw and Mana Flood in the same match. That is a recipe for disaster. So let's see what they're going to do here. And it looks like I don't even have good attacks. Right on time. A little glitchy. Which one do I care about the most? This one's going to trade with something no matter what, so. That would have, Forest probably would have won me the game if I drew it last turn. So we go to combat, put our opponent to six, and hopefully I can muddle some way together of winning this game. For as poorly as this has gone, I mean, I might be winning. I might be like a little close to winning. My opponent's cards are like not good, and they don't have a creature that can beat the Territorial Hammer Skull with the River Herald's Boon on it, I'll be okay. If my opponent has a Lightning Strike to down this thing, I will lose, almost assuredly. That's a big boy. So I need to deploy a creature next turn. Well, that's not it. That's a good draw. Oh my goodness, is this gonna... 3-4? Yeah, this will kill the Sailor of Means. Alright, that was like a pretty decent little draw there. So, I'm gonna put it on the forest. Or on a plains, I mean. Tap down the big creature. Make green green. Eat the Sailor. And I still have two cards in the grip. And this is out of range of some things. I get to eat this creature. And they can't really attack with this, otherwise I'll just tap this down and hit them for four. I could also draw +3/+3 and trample, I think, to try and win this game here. They can't be serious. Get out of here. You're not attacking. What are you thinking about? It's not lethal to win. I don't win the game with the Crushing Canopy. Not Crushing Canopy. Whatever +3/+3 and trample is. It doesn't actually end the game. So I think I should attack first to have the most information. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm one short of doing both things. Tap down. Dino. right. Let's see what my opponent's up to now. Now the canopy is almost certainly enough to give me a shot here. And this Vine Shaper Mystic will be a lethal threat as well if I don't have a good attack on the next turn. Okay, I got that game, despite being horrendously mana screwed for all of it, besides for the last three turns. All right. What else, if anything, can I do to give myself a better chance of winning this game? I think the mana is all set. I don't have a disenchant, which would be good. I have a demystify, but I don't care about demystifying that enchantment. I don't think it's worth bringing in a card on the draw. Maybe the jungle, not the jungle Delver, but the old growth dryads, just a big body for cheap mana while I'm doing stuff. They had a dual land, but they might not even have a plains. What is the worst card in my deck? I'm not sure old growth dryads is better than any other card I could play. So I guess I just have to run it back like it is with the slash. And I'm going to remember to keep the slash in the main deck for the next round, because I think I misbuilt by one card. I think I have too many lands. So I have my best card. I'm on the draw. Not great. I have decent mana, though. Let's try it. I have a ton of 2-drops to draw to. I wish this Vampire Zeal was a slash of talons. This is, I don't think it's a risky keep, because I think it's in the range of things that can be kept, but it's, like, on the lower range of things, so. And my opponent's deck didn't seem, like, super aggressive. I mean, they had 2-drops, but I'm going to need this to hit a creature, I think. Is going to be very important. So that it can kind of gum up this Fathom Fleet Firebrand. Oh my goodness, this is bad. Why didn't you have all your aggressive cards when my hand was full of terrible 2-drops? Alright. So I need this Wayfinder to hit here. I wish I had the Slash of Talons instead of the Vampire Seal. I guess I can try and trade with the Captain here. But the lightning strike would be kind of a problem. I think it's more important to trade with these bigger creatures, so particularly the Frenzied Raptor and the Captain Lannery Storm, because my 3/3s can hold that thing down as the game goes longer, and I can try and win with this Waker of the Wilds. So they did have a basic. I think now I don't want to just get Ford. I think I can. What are they going to do? Oh, they can pump. Duh. Okay. That was easy. So, I'm going to play New Horizons and then have pump spells up, and hopefully my opponent can't bounce and deal me a million damage. I could also just play Waker of the Wilds. I'd rather play Waker of the Wilds after I play another land and the New Horizons. So, so next turn, so they just don't have an answer to this guy, which I hopefully means they won't have an answer to the Waker of the Wilds. I've got the pump spell to protect the Waker of the Wilds from a lightning strike. So I probably will not make it. I'm not going to make a token unless they tap completely out. Now hopefully this Waker of the Wilds can bail me out of here. They may force the issue here with like an attack. Let's see what they do. So I think I should just hang out. That's probably what I will do. I could make a Raptor Companion. If I make a Raptor Companion, I can make a 3/3. I'd rather just make a 5/5. Let's just block with the 4/5 and make them use a trick here, because we have multiple tricks. So I'll let that's on the stack, so I'll let it resolve, let my opponent target, and then use Vampire Zeal. Ooh, that's a nice move. So now... let's see what he targets with the other one. All right, this is what I've dreamed about. Let's see if we can get out of this. It's looking okay so far. Just need to not time out, I guess. Oh, I should have used the mana from... I missed a point there. So I'll just keep doing this until the Shape Waker of the Wilds dies, I guess. Okay. I think I should just like hang out and make a 8/8 this turn. Make another 8/8. They have here. All right, I will 3. I'm just going to go for all of it, I guess. Maybe they didn't know I could put the counters onto the same creature or something. So I think I'm just going to bash with the 15-15 and just play all these creatures. If they don't chump at, I can kill them, so they have to block. This card is insane. I think I'll just sack a land, even though the land is pretty good. Alright, they're out of stuff. This is my time to shine with this Waker of the Wilds. I'm just going to pass the turn and make another 5/5. I got to get this game over with. The only way I can really lose is the one-sided upheaval. I have 4 creatures. I have 3 blockers. I just want to make it 5/5. So get in for this way, this has to get chump locked every turn now. If I don't care if they make that trade there. All right. What did we learn? Waker of the Wilds, pretty darn good. See you in a minute for round two, guys. Hello, everybody. Welcome to round two of this Ixalan draft with green-white Dino Merfolks. Seems fine. I'll keep. Last round was pretty exciting. That third game, I was in a lot of trouble and wound up being able to pull it out, so hopefully I can play some games from the front foot where I don't have to be in such a rough spot the whole game. The ending was a little anticlimactic because it was just my 15-15, you know, making my opponent chump block for the rest of their life, but what are you gonna do? So which one do I prefer? And there's a case to be made for either one. The thing I don't want to happen is to not be able to attack. So I'm going to save. I don't want to use this combat trick because I want to play the Wayfinder next turn. I guess I could also play Bishop into New Horizons is pretty sweet. Okay, that's a... After 5 seconds of thinking, the play was very clear. I really want to play Wayfinder, but New Horizons on the Bishop is like also fine. Oh, that's annoying. This is probably fine too. Well, I don't... I'll see what happens. There's different things that I could do. So, New Horizons. The Bishop Soldier is like a fine play, but then it makes no attack. I think I'm just going to attack, and then I'll play Raptor if I need to use this Vampire Seal. A slash of Talons, though, would be like kind of a problem here. I could also just trade this Bishop off. They have the slash, they have the slash. They don't have the slash. Bring in that pressure. They're going to leave this Skyblade back, and I'll just put the New Horizons counter. Onto the Raptor Companion so it can attack. I don't have anything nice to do with the mana this turn, but it does open up the Whiptail as an option or double spelling next turn. But this is just like a free char to the face here, and it prevented a damage because my opponent didn't attack last turn, so it saved me a damage. And I'd like to press this advantage. I mean, you know, when you put your opponent on the back foot like this and they're going to try and block you down, this Crash of Ramparts has a ton of value. It's like, it's damage and mana and a, you know, and a removal spell. Let's see what they have up their sleeve here. They could have the destroy an attacking creature spell. Let's start with this. I'm going to play around that attacking creature spell. I'm just not going to attack because if I just blank all my opponent's mana for that turn and I got to do all this, I'm feeling pretty good about myself. Well, now I just feel stupid. But I can do River Herald's Boon, two counters here, and then eat that. I could attack with both, then I get in. I think it's, yeah, I'm just going to attack with the Wayfinder. Maybe I should have bashed with the companion as well. Now I'm glad I didn't, because I would have lost the companion. And they're out of cards, so I have to feel like I'm favored from this position. Oh, I shouldn't have played that. I'm going to bring in my Demystify out of my sideboard, though. Should have held that island. Oh, that's a nice draw. I'm not going to put the counters on because I'm going to draw cards off of the Wayfinder here. I mean, my opponent has to answer this or they will lose. So, yeah, exactly. I might as well draw a card to because we're just top decking against each other. So, oh, I forgot to switch the deck around. I promised you guys I would do that, and I just didn't. I am so lazy. Okay. What in the world? Planes over here. Oh, I see what happened. Okay, so we're going to board out planes. We're going to board in Demystify. And then, do I have anything for a slash of Talons? Bishops, so I like my cheap drops. Love New Horizons. I love Crash. The creatures my opponent played were actually not... Slash of Talons was not good against them, so... I'm just going to board the planes for the Demystify to take out the Ixalan's Binding and the Pacifism. And my guide to Limited, I made a big deal about talking about how important I thought the sideboard is, and another example that Demystify could wind up being really good. Okay. I don't love these one drops, but they are pretty decent raid enablers. Especially for like the two drop blue raid looter guy. It's nice. Very nice. Yeah, come at me. Well, well, well. Just go for the 8 on 2. I don't think I need to do that. But I think getting the Bishop Soldier into play is actually better, and maybe it makes my opponent less worried about the 1-1 Lance. Just attacking and crashing with ramparts is pretty nice as well. See, my opponent has no respect for this Lancer. It's like opponent didn't even want to trade this menace creature for it. So I can kind of just bash. I think I'm going to bash with the Bishop Soldier. And I doubt that they will block. I'll block with attack with the Bishop Soldier. I doubt that they'll block. And then I'll play the Raptor Companion. If they do block, I just gain 5 life and dome them for 2 and kill their guy, which is perfectly acceptable. But I didn't anticipate blocking would be happening there. You can do it. You can attack. You can bring that little Fire Shrine Keeper. So it looks like they're in kind of like blocking mode. So I'm just going to play the branch walker here and pass the turn. I mean, they didn't progress their board, so this is the secret to being good at limited, but also sometimes losing. Is that when your opponent just is obviously representing a bunch of combat tricks, just play more creatures and don't attack. I know my attacks are good. I'm not taking them because my opponent missed a land drop, and all they can do is try and defend themselves with combat trick. There's no way they can defend themselves against what's about to happen to them. If, see, now they're going to tap out. Now they're going to get wrecked. Well, maybe they'll get wrecked. We'll see. But they at least recognized they had to progress the board. This is more mana efficient, but this is just better, and then I can just bash with this branch walker and make them use a combat trick, maybe. Just gonna wait. I can't, even if my opponent draws a land, I can't imagine they can make a play that impacts the board as much as that play did. I just want to pick my moment. I don't want to get blown out by Slash of Talons, which I doubt my opponent has, but... Oh no, that was last game. They didn't have it last game. Okay, so now I'm going to make a move, I think. Back to leaving all that mana up. All right, they drew their land. They're going to tap out. What do they got? Okay, I don't care about that. Prepare to get wrecked. It's a delicate dance. Oh, wow. Just go straight to combat. Prepare to die. Double combat trick. Get ready. It's going to be sweet. Now, what is the best way to do this? I'm going to River Herald's Boon first. Choose target creature. It's the most damage to +3/+3 on the Lancer. Put the counter on here. Put another counter on probably this one. Yeah, okay. So I'm going to put the counter on the lifelinker. I'm going to put +1/+1 on my Merfolk. Then I'm going to crash here. All right. Swing with everybody. Now you can use your combat trick. That on its own is not enough. My opponent needs something else. And a concession. Makes sense. Oh, wow. Yeah, they were kind of... I mean, we knew that they were jammed up on mana. That's why I did what I did. So, all right. Got two rounds with the unconventional green-white dino deck, but really it's just a green white beatdown deck. Gonna try and go for that that trophy, that medal, that 3-0 in the next round. So see you everybody in a minute. Thanks for tuning in. Hey everybody, welcome back. Brian DeMars for round three of this Ixalan draft with green white dinos going for the trophy. I won the die roll, so yeah, I should probably play first, I suppose. My green white beatdown deck. I got all my colors. I got a curve. I'm ready to play, so I'll keep it. And I'll play planes. I wrote a primer. Well, it came out today as of when I'm doing the draft, but I wrote it last week about how to draft the format, and I'm really just implementing the skills that I wrote about in that format. It's called How to Draft Ixalan, and it focuses on common structure, knowing the archetypes, and drafting on a curve. And although I sort of strayed out of archetype a little bit by going green-white because that was what was open, I stuck with the curve, and I feel like it's paid off pretty well. I think I'm just going to develop my board here. I don't want to waste a combat trick on a grizzly bear to push a grizzly bear through. Even if it is a good grizzly bear. My opponent has a bad grizzly bear. So I'm just going to develop my board a little bit, see what's up, and try and get the most value out of this removal. That's a good target for that little removal. Just hope they have like five more ranging raptors in their hand. So, unfortunately, I just have to attack here and accept the trade. This hand was a lot better before it drew a bunch of lands, which is... I still didn't fix my deck. Well, at least, you know what? We did it fair and square. Fair and square, we did it. But I will sideboard out that land. No wonder I'm flooded. I have only myself to blame. Too many lands. So I can just trample on through this grazing whiptail. And hopefully I just draw like all spells for the rest of my life. to... Oh, I had it right. What am I doing? So I'll play that. Drop a land. Go for two. They didn't fall for it. I thought maybe if I... Yeah, they, I guess they have to know that there's a trick there. They could think I'm bluffing, I guess. Well, the attack with both three, I won't be able to save anything, so I think I just have to let this go. I'll kind of lose everything if I make this attack, and I won't really gain anything. You know, I have good draws in my deck, so, you know, I'd rather wait to do something that's going to actually work than something that is, you know, like 90% to fail. Yeah, let's take that. I don't... This is still not a very good attack, and my opponent has all their mana up, so... You know, I have life to work with. I'm at 26 from all the Bishop Soldier beats and the Ravenous Dagger Claw, so... And a lot of my pieces are synergy pieces, so I don't necessarily just want to throw things away willy-nilly. They are making some progress on my life total, but I'm trying to get something that'll allow me to... Oh my goodness. Deals combat damage for player. Well, I guess I can try and fight this in combat. It's going to take... Or I can just do this. I think now is the time for the beats. Oh my goodness, I didn't play land. I'm so bad. I thought I played it. Well, that should have been much, much better than it turned out to be. Let's see if I can still get the win. I knew what I wanted to do, and then I didn't do it correctly. But I should still have that Bishop Soldier and... Oh, goodness. Six. Be a 6/4, so I guess I have to come over the top again. Okay. So I can 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just make a big dino. Can I attack with it this turn? 1, 2, 3. It'll only be a 5/5. I'll just make a 6/6. I'm going to make the plains into the big land. So I'll just attack with the land, and that will force my opponent to chump with something. No cards, so I only need to make it 7. I'm just gonna go for all of it. Good combat. Attack with my 10/10. Let's make another 10/10. Start on another land. All right. This card is, it's okay. It's pretty good. Not gonna lie. Decent card. All right, so I did want to board out a land, although being flooded there was pretty grand. What did they have? What did I care about? I think I just want Slash of Talons. This isn't a deck for Demystify. Well, I think I want any of this other stuff. Got to get them dead because they have a lot of good big things to ramp into. So I'm just kind of looking to see what I have. I think it's just Slash of Talons. This looks pretty decent. I love that I assembled my Merfolk combo once. As long as I draw land, I should be alright. I mean, that's a strong start. And this will help me dig for it. Even with that terrible, terrible misplay, where I didn't play the land. I got so excited because I had it all. We've seen that happen before on camera at Pro Tours. Just get excited because you got it, and you don't have it anymore. I actually want to play Vine Shaper Mystic here. Let me think about this. I don't have like another pump spell. I could just play New Horizons this turn, then I'll have 5 mana next turn and I can go. I want to be able to play the I think I'm just going to play the Vine Shaper here. It'll give me options for next turn. And I can definitely double spell next turn. Maybe I should just trade this off here. I'm just going to trade it off. No, I'm not. I have a shock. I'll probably get more value if I wait. So I feel like this attack with this 2/4 is pretty free. Is it though? I think I'm just gonna bat. No, I shouldn't attack into all this mana. I should progress my board. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play New Horizons. I'll put the counter on the Imperial Lancer. And then I'm going to play the Bishop's Soldier. still fine. Okay. Now I'm going to attack with both. I'll shock whatever gives me the most value. I'd rather kill this. I mean, that's definitely a card. Need a pump spell now. This could theoretically work. Got to draw one of my good cards. Any of my good cards will like bail me out here. Oh my gosh. All right, now we need very specific things. God, that would have been nice last turn, huh? All right, 3-0 with the green-white Mer Dinos. So, I didn't think that that was necessarily a 3-0 deck, but I got my 3-0 with it, and I'm happy. Another trophy for my Magic Online account collection there. I think that's more realistically like a 2-1 kind of a deck. It's a little off the rails. But if it followed sound philosophy, which is what I'm working on in draft, and it executed because it was based in sound logic. It is an aggressive deck. It has a great curve. And that's what this format is all about. It's way easier to play, from the front foot than the back foot. My opponent was on the back foot. And, you know, they had that last game, two charging Monstrodons. And it just didn't matter because I'm playing from ahead. They can't really use it. That card is powerful when it attacks, not when it blocks. When it sits there and you can't do anything with it, it's not doing the work that you need it to do. You know, you can't take advantage of the haste or the trample when you're trying to block with it. So anyway, be sure to check out that article, How to Draft Ixalan. It's on Channel Fireball right now. It is a great, I'm not going to, you know, toot my own horn or anything, but I think it's a very sound way to learn the fundamentals of the format, which is what I did here today to get this 3-0. So be sure to check that out. If you like the video, be sure to hit the like button on there. And, if you like it, subscribe to the Channel Fireball YouTube channel. There's a lot of great content on there. It's a great way to stay ahead of the pack, whether you're, you know, drafting a Friday Night Magic or, you know, practicing Modern for an RPTQ. All of those formats are covered, and a lot of really, really good content providers for ChannelFireball.com doing some really excellent work. So be sure to check those out. Also, if you have any comments, be sure to drop those in the comment section for me. I read them. I respond to them. I'm pretty active in responding in my comment section. So, you know, that was an interesting draft. I'll be sure to go back and watch it after it goes posted live. But I'm curious about the picks and how I did there. You know, there was some weird stuff with some tension between should we be vampires? Do I want to be green? I don't love green in a, you know, an aggressive deck necessarily when it's not merfolk, but we sort of just became a merfolk deck even though I wasn't in the merfolk colors. Those merfolk are